they have to actually conclude, you know, what dimensions and what the Bible verses is be saying. Like, praise the name of the Lord. Give glory to the God of Israel. Worship in him. Sing in the Lord. And this same Lord to the earth, from above this heavens or this kingdom, this life in a form of food, me, body, in a form of what it is that you can actually be according to an immortal life thereby. You know, it's like none other food that we can eat to actually live to immortal life thereby. But Jesus Christ. Now, this food, we call him Jesus Christ today. We will call him Jesus, and we will call him the Christ, and we will ask him to be our blessings. You know, to be our prayer and to lead us through the Holy Spirit's fire. You know, the ghost of all truth. To lead us through to the way that is initiated to what this life has to pertain. That we have to fight with beasts, according to St. Paul. That we have to be taking up serpents. That we have to actually contend with what evil purposes, the desires of the wicked ones is. To actually overcome them. You know, all of the desires are things to make you feel the hole that someone will dig for you to go down inside. Which part you will end up? If I dig a hole for my viewer here today, which part my viewer will end up? In the hole, or I will end up in the hole? My viewers will end up on top, and I will end up inside of the hole. But that's not hard for none of us to see. That's literally easy for any of us to bear. That we can live a dynasty of life. You know, a wealth of paradise of glories and, you know, hosannas and praise. But Jesus showed them that they can end up in the fire of hell. Now, I don't know why. Because we can see a luxury car, a Maybach, you know, or a private jet, or somebody living in a palace, you know, an estate of life, you know, a mansion worth about $100 million. But we see them today in the world that their life looking most wonderful. Exhilarating, that you want to captivate it, but at the same time you yourself want to actually say that the cruel, the crooked, or the bad. So it doesn't really have a place that actually holds the judgment that what it is Jesus does hold. The judgment is not given to men, it's given to Jesus Christ, and Jesus Christ is given the Holy Spirit of God. That is for you to receive. In believing in the name of the Lord. In calling on the name of the only Lord. And he will be safe. If he's there with you. If he doesn't have God, you have Jesus. Same with school. If you have Jesus, you have God. Now today, do I know if I have Jesus? I have a confession. You know, that I actually need him here and I cannot feel the presence of God drawing close to actually put something forward for the guys. That deep inside of my moans, that deep inside of my groans, I can actually feel others provoking me. You know, like spirits rolling through my beam of my eyes that I can see and they want to be provoking me. You know, I mean, why is it that I have something good to do, they want to do evil with me? It doesn't want me to be good. It want me to be evil with them. So it come like the making a bed or the foot to go down into hell, but they want to catch me to go down into it. That's like digging a hole for me to fall down in. But I'm not going to fall in the hole. You know? God. This Lord God. Watch him good. This Lord God is not a hole. There is no hole here. There is only blessings here. None of the words. Nothing you can do to break this. Nothing. Nothing. Nothing can be done that this Bible can be broken. Nothing. All of the blessings that's be here. This Bible is blessed. You be contented with this, they will be trampling you down. You be going down and down and down. They will press you down. You be contended into something like what this is. In the revelations, they tell you that if whosoever keepeth the words of the prophecy of this book, they'll be blessed. For whoso taketh the words of the prophecy out of this book, God will take away his part.